y'all. Nana here. I hope that everybody's doing fine and dandy. Oh, I am worn out, y'all. I am worn out. I had my babies again yesterday, and I tell you what, they have worn Nana out. But if you listen real close, you'll hear that my house is nice and quiet. I got the whole house to myself today. And I did wake up this morning with the intentions of getting up, doing housework and laundry and, you know, all that. But I thought, to hell with it. I'm tired. I'm tired and I'm going to take a me day today. Because I need a me day to recuperate and just spend time doing the things I enjoy. So I thought I'd catch up on YouTube, and I think I'm going to check out a documentary on Netflix that a few people have suggested about that whole Ted Bundy. Mm-hmm. So I might do that later on, but I thought, why not do coffee and chit-chat? Yeah, I didn't get to finish up saying all the things I wanted to say in the other bit, too, but let's see what I want to... Oh, let's talk about the girl that's pudgy and pregnant. My God, y'all, is that girl ever happy? Is she ever happy? She must be the most miserable person on the planet, y'all. I have never heard anything positive come out of that mouth of hers. Now, I don't watch her channel. I just can't. I can't with that one, But I've been watching the clips on Twitter, and that's enough for me to just know that she's miserable. She's straight up miserable. All she does is bleach and moan. She moaning about being pregnant. She moaning about not being able to breathe. She's bleaching about that milk mustache of hers. She's bleaching about the 2-year-old acting like a 2-year-old. She's crying about the haters. The other day, she was crying about the crappy service she got at her fast food restaurant. Then I saw a clip just a little while ago. She's crying about them making her wait so long to get into her appointment. Then they made her hold her pee-pee for 2 hours. Y'all, how could they treat her like that? Don't they know that she's with child? Where's the red carpet? Why didn't they roll out the red carpet for her, the queen of misery? My God, and what the hell? I tell you, that one right there, she's delusional. She is a crusty, mean, miserable woman. I wouldn't want nothing to do with that one. Man, I feel sorry for her family. I feel sorry for people that are in her vicinity. I tell you that. She just creates her own misery. That poor child of hers. Probably like, Mama, shut up. That baby inside probably like, oh God, here we go again. Leave me alone, Mama. My God, I have never come across somebody who's so miserable in their life. Miserable. I mean, I get it. Okay, she's pregnant. Let her bleach and moan. But geez Louise, it's every day with that one. Every damn clip I see, she's just bleaching and moaning. You know, I mean, I've been pregnant a time or two, and I was not expecting special treatment. But this one, geez Louise, she just thinks the whole world just needs to revolve around her and her big old belly. I don't get it. I mean, when I was pregnant, I was happy. I was joyful. This girl, I never seen her be happy or joyful. I mean, yeah, you get miserable, but I wasn't miserable till the end of my pregnancy when I was 9 months along. I couldn't see my feet. And I was over the 115-degree weather that I was dealing with. This girl don't do nothing. She's always at home. What does she do all day long? She's at home all day. She gets up, takes her medications, takes a nap, puts on makeup, takes a nap again. I don't know. My God, what a sad existence. That's a sad, miserable life. I don't want it. I'm going to stop talking about it because I don't want my day to be miserable. And no, she don't bring out no good to nobody. And then that gum ASMR chew thing. Nope, can't. I'm done talking about that one. I'm sorry I even brought that one up. I can't. Oh my God, misery. Woo! Ew, that one just leaves a sour taste in my mouth. Don't like her. Alright, so let's see. Okay, so in my last bit to you, I was talking about the divorce, the fake divorce. Y'all, it's fake. It's fake. They ain't getting no damn divorce, okay? They ain't. I've seen that go down one too many times to know that it's all fake. No divorce. But yesterday I was tweeting with somebody on the Twitter, and I was saying, what do y'all expect? This woman ain't gonna change. She ain't gonna change. She's been doing this forever, since 1993. She ain't gonna change. She likes the drama. She likes the attention. She'll do anything to try to get famous. She wants to be famous so bad. That's just sad. That's sad. You know, she wants to be famous. I wouldn't want that. Too much goes with that. I mean, the woman is trying to do anything she can to provoke old drama. Look, she's over there shouting out my girl Wendy. You know, so, trying to pull her back in the drama. The thing is, Wendy don't care. Wendy don't talk about you. Wendy don't care about your drama. Nobody cares about your drama. She keeps on trying to provoke these people that she's been, you know, dealing with drama with. They don't want to play no more. They don't want to play no more because they know it's a never-ending cycle of stupid games with this one. But I did see that now she's trying to ride the coattails of a Molly Golightly. Been talking about her nonstop. But yet, everybody's obsessed with the drama queen. Yet, she's the one talking about people, dropping people's names in her videos left and right. I don't know much about this Molly Golightly person, but I'll tell you what, I know exactly what the drama queen's trying to do. She's trying to do dick ride, as they call it. That's all she's trying to do. She wants new subscribers, she wants more attention, so she's gonna keep on using this lady's name. That's what she does. Well, she's saying, oh, Molly would be the kind of person I have a relationship with. I think she's attractive. Oh, she's hot. Nah, girl, the only thing you're interested in is trying to steal her subs, steal her views, get her notoriety. That's what you want. That's what you's attracted to right there. I'm hip to your game, girl. I know. Been watching you long enough to know how you work, and that's how you work. Yeah, but I don't think anything's going to come of that. I think they're both very big personalities, but to be quite honest with you, from the things that I've seen with the Molly Golightly, I think she's on a whole nother level than the drama queen. Now, the drama queen wants to be on that level, but I don't think it's going to happen for her. If it hasn't happened now, it ain't going to happen. But anyway, that would be interesting to see when they blow up at each other. Because we all seen it before. We all seen that the drama queen tries to get friendly with somebody. And then something happens and it blows up. And hooey, we're back at the drama. That's what the woman does. She's drama. Drama. One other thing I want to talk about is, you know what? I'm getting real sick and tired of hearing people say that Rebecca cannot have an independent life. I don't understand it, nor do I accept it, because it's complete bullshit. It's bullshit. I have had people in my life that I have seen have issues and live independently. I've got a friend that's got some issues, and she finally got away from her manipulative mother and has been living independently for 10 years now. I got another friend whose sister has Down syndrome. She married a boy that had autism. That's right, I said married. And they're living on their own in their cute little apartment with the fur babies. And they're doing just fine living independently. Now that's the thing. There are programs out there to help people with these issues. And if they reach out to the right places, they're going to help. But you know what's made them most successful at their independent living? It's been the support they get from their family and their friends. The family and their friends are there to help them when they need the help. When they call out and say, can you help me? That's what's gotten them through this far, is the support. And I tell you right now, I know that Rebecca will not be getting support from her mama. I've said it before and I'll say it again. Her mama's just going to try to sabotage anything she tries to do. And that's sad. That sure is sad. But you know what? I'm one of the people that want to see Rebecca gain an independent life. So I'm going to be pulling for her and wishing her the best. Alright, well, I think that's going to be it for right now. I'm a little hungry, so I think I'm going to find me something to eat and then sit down and watch that documentary. But you know what's funny, y'all? When I take a break from YouTube and then I come back to this stuff, I'm like, man, what the hell's wrong with you? Why are you sitting here getting entertainment watching these nutbags? I don't get it. I mean, why am I wasting my time? But I do. I guess it's because, like, I'm a people person and I like to try to figure people out. But it's just a whole circle of craziness. That's what it is. But anyhow, hey, look, and I know people who I've talked about, they're probably like, well, why are you talking about me? Don't talk about me. Look, if I'm watching, I'm going to talk about you. I don't care. If you like it, you don't like it. I don't care. Don't watch me. But I want you to be watching. Keep on watching. But yeah, if I watch something I want to talk about, I'm going to talk about it. It's my channel. It's my freedom to have my opinion, and I'm going to voice my opinion. Mm-hmm. So whatever. Give me a lecture. Don't talk about me. I'll talk about you if I won't. And real quick, before I go, I just want to say thank you so much to everybody who records the videos and posts the clips. Thank y'all so much. You know, people delete their streams, and I ain't got no time to be sitting there for 4 hours watching a stream. But I just want to say thank you. Thank you so much for posting the clips so I can get caught up some. So big old shout out to Stewie, to Kaylee, to Morgan, to Paula, and to anybody else who puts clips out there, thank y'all so much. I appreciate it, because that way I can get caught up, because I'm always lost, y'all. I don't pay attention enough to know what's going on, but the clips help me out, so thank y'all so much. But that's all I got for y'all right now. Remember, Nana's always watching. Nana's always watching.